everyone! In this video I'm going to show you my top 7 of Outbreak and Virus TV shows. I made this video 2 years ago, but this one is the updated version and the quality of both audio and video is way better. If you want to see the old version, I will link that down below. The order of the shows is based only of my personal judgment and thoughts, and I will not mention zombie shows because I've already done that in another video that I will link down below too. So without further ado, let's get into the video. At number 7, there is a 2015 American television series on sci-fi. It is a science fiction mystery drama with a time-traveling plot loosely adapting the 1995 film of the same name. It is... Monkeys follows the journey of a time traveler from the post-apocalyptic future who appears in the present day on a mission to locate and eradicate the source of a deadly plague that will nearly destroy the human race. I put this show at number 7 because, first of all, it's not really about viruses, even though it is the cause of everything, but it's more so about time traveling. And for that, this show is at number 7. At number 6, there is a Canadian science fiction drama television series which debuted on 2015. I'm talking about... Between is the story of a small town called Pretty Lake and surrounding rural area under siege from a mysterious disease that has wiped out everybody aged 22 and older. This series also explores numerous themes, the power vacuum that results when the government quarantines a 10 square mile zone and leaves the inhabitants to fend for themselves, the desire of inhabitants to escape, ignoring that they will spread the deadly disease to the entire planet, and the effect of hormonal teenage young adult angst becoming the guiding force for an entire community. Now, this show is a number 6 because, first of all, it is about virus, so it's definitely a step forward than Between. But the acting is very poor. The characters, the actors have no facial expression and they don't communicate their feelings very well. So, for this reason mainly, it is a number 6. Number 5 is taken by a Danish post-apocalyptic web television series which premiered on Netflix in 2018. It is... When a virus that is carried by rainfall wipes out almost all humans in Scandinavia, Danish siblings Simone and Rasmus take shelter in a bunker. 6 years later, they emerge to search for their father, a scientist who left them in the bunker but never returned. Along the way, they join a group of young survivors and together they travel across Denmark and Sweden, searching for a safe place and for the siblings' father who may be able to provide the answers and the cure. This show is a number 5 because, in my opinion, it focuses on surviving more than finding a cure. Although, throughout the 2 seasons that are currently out right now, there are hints about a cure, about someone that knows something. But since the protagonists are teenagers and young adults, they don't know much about it, and so they're trying to find answers they cannot really understand. But overall, it is a nice show. At number 4, there is a 2014 American action drama television series, loosely based on the 1988 novel of the same name by William Brinkley. It is... After a global viral pandemic wipes out over 80% of the world's population, the crew, consisting of 218 people of a lone and effective US Navy missile destroyer, the fictional USS Nathan James, must try to find a cure, stop the virus, and save humanity. This show has a great potential. The first season is very good, because it shows the pandemic, people's death, the precautions you have to take, and especially the search for a cure. But after season 1, the idea of virus and outbreak fades away. In fact, there are no more pandemic, there are no more viruses, but there are more political problems related to rebuilding humanity in a way. So, if you want to watch this show, which is really good in my opinion, be sure to have the right intentions. If you want a virus, watch season 1. After that, be aware that it won't be any more virus and epidemics. At number 3, there is an American horror drama television series that aired on Fox in 2014. It was created by Guillermo del Toro and Chuck Hogan, based on their novel trilogy of the same name. The show on number 3 is... The strain centers around Dr. Ephraim Goodweather, the head of the CDC's New York-based Canary Project, who is called upon to investigate an airplane landing wherein everyone aboard is dead. What his team discovers is a viral outbreak that has similarities to an ancient strain of vampirism. The virus begins to spread and Goodweather works with his team and a group of the city's residents to wage a war to save humanity. Personally, I put this show on number 3 because it is very interesting. Because it's not just a normal virus, and it's not just a normal vampirism, the one you know from the Vampire Diaries or Twilight or whatever. It's a total and completely different thing, and it's so interesting because the show mixes a myth to science, and there's nothing more interesting than that. Also, the science part of the show is quite present. Not as much as we're going to see in the next shows I'm going to talk about, but it's still pretty cool. At number 2, there is an American limited series based on a Belgian television series Cardon. The series was officially ordered as a series by the CW in 2015. It is... Containment follows an epidemic that breaks out in Atlanta, leaving a section of the city cordoned off under quarantine, and those stuck inside fighting for their lives. This show is one of my favorites of all time, because it's about love, loss, and duty, and the actors are amazing, and they tell multiple stories, and we have multiple points of view. And also the virus is studied pretty well, but not as in deep as the show in the first place. Before continuing with the video and revealing the first place, I have two shows that are bonuses and that I haven't watched, so I cannot give my personal opinion, but based on what I could see and guess from the trailers and articles that I read about them, this is what I can tell you. The fourth bonus is The Passage, and it is a 2019 American thriller television series based on a trilogy of novels. And the trauma is the following. When a botched US government experiment turns a group of death row inmates into highly infectious vampires, an orphan girl might be the only person able to stop the ensuing crisis. Again, this one deals with vampirism too, but similar to The Strain, it is caused by a virus. So this is interesting because, like I said earlier, it mixes mythology with science. The last bonus is V-Wars. V-Wars is an American science fiction horror web television series based on the eponymous novel series and graphic novels by Jonathan McBerry. The series stars Ian Somerhalder, also known as Damon Salvatore in The Vampire Diaries. It premiered on Netflix on December 5th, 2019. V-Wars follows the story of the physician scientist Dr. Luther Swan and his best friend Michael Fain as they face the evolving crisis of a deadly outbreak that fractures society into opposing factions, potentially escalating to a future war between humans and vampires. Apparently, vampirism connected to a virus is the theme, is a recurring theme of the past years. That's all I can say. But I'm telling you, the show number one is not about vampires. And the first place is taken by an American science fiction horror drama television series that aired on Sci-Fi in 2014. Did you guess what it is? The series follows a team of scientists from the CDC who travels to a research facility in the Arctic to investigate a potential outbreak of disease. While there, they find themselves stuck in a life or death situation that could decide the future of humankind. Elix is my favorite outbreak show because in the first season the virus is really the protagonist and we can see the scientists really working to find a cure. I also love the anxious atmosphere that hovers during the episodes. Plus, the characters are well developed and the chosen music is particular and great. This is the end of the video, thank you for watching. If you liked it, be sure to leave a like, a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe and activate the bell so you can be notified whenever I post. If you have any other suggestions of videos that I could do, whether they are tops, they're about films, TV shows, whatever you want me to do, just write it down below and I will do it. Thank you for this experience. Bye!